So hello students, we are discussing here one of the numerical based on the impulse invariance method. Let's say the numerical is like we need to obtain h of z and h of s is given to us. Let's say h of s is nothing but 2 by s plus 1 into s plus 2, and the frequency, sampling frequency for this method is given. Let's assume that it is nothing but the 5 hertz. This is what the fs given. This particular numerical was asked many times in the exam. It was asked in December 2007, 8, 10 as well as 13. So earlier when the subject was with the 100 marks, then the weightage for this example was actually 8 marks. So let's discuss this. So here h of s is given to us. If we just find out the steps or randomly provide the steps for designing the IR filter with the help of the impulse invariance method, we will be able to just transfer it from h of s to h of z, but with certain steps, because we started the discussion of h of s with the help of the partial fraction. Means the h of s we have written in terms of the partial fraction expression. Then we converted that 1 upon s minus pk into 1 upon 1 minus e raised to pk ts z inverse. Similarly, we have seen the expressions for s plus a by s plus a square plus b square, as well as b by s plus a square plus b square. But right now this particular example is quite suitable for the simple arrangement, that 1 upon s plus 1 and 1 upon s plus 2. So why not to go for the partial fraction arrangement for this h of s? So that could be the very first stage which we can go for. And after that, whatever the h of s we just factorized into the partial fractions value, then simply by using the expression like 1 upon s minus pk, which will give us 1 upon 1 minus e raised to pk ts z inverse. So this particular thing will convert the s domain into the z domain, and that's it. That is where our job of digital IR filter design will be done. Now for doing this, let's proceed to get the partial fraction expansion for this h of s. So I will write it like this. H of s is equal to, let's say it is a by s plus 1, and here it is b by plus b by s plus 2. So a and b, these are the two unknown values which we have seen. So here if someone want to summarize this, poles for this one will be s is equal to minus 1 and second pole will be at minus 2. So these are the two pole values. Now let's find out the value of a. A can be easily obtained simply by using the statement s plus 1 into h of s, that too at s is equal to minus 1. So if this is what done, so s plus 1 into h of s means it is the value, let's say this is what the equation number 1 which we started with. So into h of s means 2 by s plus 1 into s plus 2. So this s plus 1 will be cancelled. So it will reduce to the value 2 by s plus 2. So just put the s equal to minus 1. So 2 by 1. So that is 2. So this is how the a will be reduced to value 2. Let's proceed for calculating the b. For calculating the b, it is simply s plus 2 into h of s, that is at s is equal to minus 2. So what is it? So s plus 2. Rest of the things will be same, that is 2 by s plus 1 into s plus 2. So s plus 2 cancel. So it will be 2 by s plus 1, that is at minus 2. S is equal to minus 2. So this value will be simply replaced over here. So it is minus 2 plus 1, that is minus 1. And this value will constitute result as a minus 2. So this is how a and b will be obtained. Let's put it in the equation number 2. Now in the equation number 2, when we put these values, the equation will look like h of s is equal to a is 2, so 2 by s plus 1, b is minus 2, so it is written like this, minus 2 by s plus 2. Now once this equation is formed, now let's compare it with the equation that is written over here. So this is what the equation. So here for this first part, the pk is nothing but the value, we can say it is minus 1, and here the value of pk is nothing but minus 2. So just replace the same values, and before replacing that we can just calculate here the ts. What is ts? Ts is nothing but the sampling time, so it is 1 upon fs. So 1 by 5, that is nothing but 0.2 second, that is what the ts. So just replace the value ts equal to 0.2 in this equation and rearrange the equations. This is how it will give, let's say, conversion from s to z. So that is why this will become h of z is equal to 2 into, for this 1 upon s plus 1, directly I will write it 1 upon s plus 1 means 1 upon the value of pk as a minus 1. So it can be written as a 1 upon 1 minus e raised to minus 0.2 z inverse, because obviously that value is nothing but what? Why this 0.2 is written? It is because ts equal to 0.2, and minus 1, that is nothing but the value of which value? That is nothing but the pk. So pk is nothing but minus 1. Similarly, minus 2 into the next value, which we can just write down here, that is for this term s plus 2. So let's write it for the second term. So I will write it with the different colors so that it will be well understood to you. So for this second, so this can be rearranged. Let's say pole is minus 2 over here, so 1 upon 1 minus e raised to minus 2 into 0.2, because it is pkts, so this will become minus 0.4 into z inverse. So this is how it will be changed. Now for this to have the more effective, let's solve it further. So h of z will be equal to what? This can be written as it, simply rearrange it, 2 by 1 minus e raised to minus 0.2 z inverse minus 2 by 1 minus e raised to minus 0.4 z inverse. So this is what the digital IR filters transfer function. If you want, you can solve it further also. Now by rearranging the terms, let me write it for the further two more stages. So h of z, so this is what the h of z, let's write it here, is equal to 2 by 1 minus e raised to minus 0.2 is nothing but 0.818 z inverse minus 2 by 1 minus e raised to minus 0.4, it is nothing but 0.67 z inverse. Now let's simplify it further. After cross multiplication, you will be able to write it like h of z is equal to, let's cross multiply it, 2z by z minus 0.818, by rearranging the terms, minus 2z by z minus 0.67. So this is how, this is nothing but the h of z obtained for the given h of s with the help of the impulse invariance method. So thank you everyone, thank you very much.